Good afternoon. Good afternoon, all of you. Today, we are here for conduction of the practical electronic circuit lab. So, it is a companion course of electronic circuits in theory, and the course code is 204185. So, this is the syllabus structure or course structure you can see for this particular lab. So it is a practical. There is no tutorial. There is no in-sem or end-sem or term work is there. So it is a directly external practical examination of 50 marks. 2 hours of practicals per week would be conducted throughout this semester. And it is having the 1 credit. If we go on to the syllabus of this electronic circuits lab, there have the 3 groups of practical. All the practicals have been divided into the 3 groups. In the first group, that is based on the first 3 units. And in the group A, there are the 5 practicals listed. Out of that, minimum 4 we have to be performed. Which are these? So first practical that we are going to implement today, that is design, build or simulate a single stage CS amplifier and verify the DC operating point. Second, the succession of this practical, and we would be apply the analog signal on the same amplifier design and find out the voltage gain, input resistance, output resistance as well as the bandwidth. Means we would be check frequency response. Third one is we would be implement the current series feedback amplifier based on the same circuit. In all these first 3 practicals, we are going to use the MOSFET. Because as per our syllabus also, so all these first 4 practicals are based on the first 2 units. Fourth one is the MOSFET amplifier based beam bridge oscillator. And the 5th practical is based on the 3rd unit, that is based on the voltage regulator. And here we have to be design and implement the adjustable voltage regulator using the 3-terminal voltage regulator IC. So these are the first group practicals are there. Next, group B. Here there is no any option. It is compulsory to implement all these 4 practicals. 6th number is to measure the following op-amp parameters, compare with the specification in data sheet. Okay. Or any op-amp you can use, either LM741, OP07, whatever the list is given here. And you have to find out various parameters like input bias current, offset current, offset voltage, input slew rate, CMRR. 7th one is to design, build and test integrator using op-amp. Then 8th one is that to design and build test 2 or 3 bit R2 or ladder DAC, digital to analog converter. 9th one is the build and test the square and triangular wave generator using the op-amp LF351 or 35. So these are now up to we have know is 8 practicals. Apart from this, the group C is there. Out of 4 given, we have to be performed the any 2. So to build and test Schmitt trigger using op-amp, or the to build and test three op-amp instrumentation amplifier for typical application, to build and test the 2-bit flash ADC, or to build and test PLL circuit. These are the 4 out of that we have to perform. So in this way, we have to perform at least 10 practicals. Apart from these 10 practicals, we have also performed 2 more practicals in the virtual lab. So it is given as a note, 1 practical from each group should be performed as a simulation practical, means you can use any simulation tool like multisim. And then additional minimum 2 practical are to be performed within the virtual. So 10 practicals we have to perform in our lab and 2 practicals we have to perform in the virtual lab. We will be also see which virtual labs are suggested as per the syllabus. In this way, we have to be complete 12 practicals throughout this semester. So the syllabus it is bulky. So we have to attend each and every session so that we would be able to complete these practicals within stipulated time. Which are the virtual labs suggested by the university? First one is for IIT. This is the virtual lab. IIT Bombay has designed this virtual lab. We have to go through this link and we can perform any of the 2 practicals out of the listed 13 practicals. And basic electronics virtual lab, there this is designed by the IIT Kharagpur, that it would be also used. You can refer this link or either from this slide or either from the syllabus copy, and you can also go and experience what is a virtual lab. But at initial phase, I am not referring this. I am just go for the our practicals in our lab or either in the simulation service. Now we have to come to our first practical. So what is our first practical? The first practical is to design, simulate and test single stage common source amplifier and verify DC operating point. So this circuit already we have discussed in the theory. We have to just little bit see the overview of that and then learn how to design this and then simulate on the simulation software, that is multi. Okay, now first of all, what are the objective of this practical? Objective says there are the some objective. First objective is to understand design of a voltage divider bias DC circuit for CS configured e-MOSFET to find RG1, RG2, RD and RS. So we have to be design a voltage divider bias DC circuit for CS configuration in such a way that we have to be find out 4 resistors. Out of this 4 resistors, there is a 2 resistors are the biasing resistors. One is source, another is drain resistor. Second objective is to obtain DC operating point parameters such as IDQ, VGSQ, VDSQ using the simulation. Okay, and here we are using the simulation tool as, here we would be use a simulation tool as Multisim. It is very popular and tested software from a long term in the Pune University. Now we see what is the outcome of that practical. What you would be learn and what you would be able to do after performing this practical. You would be able to perform or design a DC voltage divider bias circuit for CS configured e-MOSFET amplifier application for given specification. You have to be give some specification in the question of design. Simulate and validate the variable using modern. I think there is some problem. Again, I am sharing the screen. So second outcome is simulate and validate using modern simulation tool to analyze the DC voltage divided by a CS configured e-MOSFET circuit to find the DC operating. These are the 2 outcomes are there. 2 objective and 2 outcomes are there. You have to be fulfilled. And the software required is multisim. Component we are going to use here, this is a key component, N-channel enhancement type MOSFET 2N7000. Note down the number of the MOSFET. This is very much important. 2N7000. It is the N-channel enhancement type MOSFET. Now come to the little bit theory we will be discussed for this practical. So in this practical, we have to be draw the DC load line and find out the DC operating point. So first of all, we have to be little bit know about the what is the concept of load line and DC load line. So the word DC indicates that this load line is drawn under the DC operating conditions without any AC signal at the input. And the word load line is used, if you have to be see, the word load line is used here. Because the slope of this line is reciprocal of the sum of resistances in the drain and source circuit. The one end point defined as drain to source voltage, drain to source voltage means VDS. With VDD applied when the MOSFET is in the cutoff region, okay. And other end would be defined when drain to source voltage with the VDD in applied with the fully conducting mode. In this way, we have to find out the VDS max and ID max, and by using these two extreme points, we would be draw a straight line. That is considered as a DC load line. Now, the DC load line for the MOSFET circuit is drawn on the device output or drain characteristics. Already we have discussed in the theory that first of all, to draw this DC load line, we have to be draw the drain characteristics or output characteristics. That is the characteristic curve drawn between ID versus VDS for the various value of the VGS. For n-channel common source MOSFET circuit, the load line equation is given by VDS is equal to VDD minus ID RD plus RS. In the theory, we have not considered the RS, but here in the practical, we would be considered. So you can see little bit change in the equation. Here, ID multiplied with the RD plus RS because there is a source resistor in the circuit. Now, the other important aspect of this practical, that is find out the operating point or Q point, you can say quiescent point. So what is operating point? The term quiescent means still, quiet or inactive. The Q point is also called an operating point or bias point. It identifies the device current IDQ and terminal voltages VDSQ and VGSQ when there is no AC input signal. This is completely DC condition. Okay. So it is very important to know this terminology like DC load line, operating point, then and then only you would be able to design and implement this practice. So when the MOSFET is biased for use as an amplifier, if no input is provided, the amplifier would be operate at its Q point. When input is applied to the gate, ID varies according to the instantaneous amplitude of the signal and produce a variation of ID also. This is the property of basic amplifier. However, the operating point would be moved based on the changes in the VGS. So generally, operating point is a stable point. But as the VGS would be vary, your Q point would be also shift on the DC load line. And as we know that for one particular operation, there is a fixed value of the VGS is applied. VGS is not variable for single operation. But for the different application, you can change the value of VGS. And as you change the value of VGS, the Q point would be shift or its value would be also changed. That would be shown through the family of curves on the DC load line diagram. So this is the basic diagram that would be shown the first of all the transistor characteristics. Then you can see there is a load line also. It will be seen in this particular. So load line is also there, voltage transfer characteristics, and as well as we have to also indicate the Q point. So this is the Y axis where we have to be show the ID, and it is the x-axis where we have to be see the VDS. Okay, first of all, we have to be draw the transistor characteristics. This is the curve that would be drawn here for the different value of VGS. So this is the VGS first one, then VGS two, that is also there is the VGS Q, then VGS 3 is there. Like this, if you would be vary the value of VGS, the curve would be shift upward direction. And as for the operating regions of the transistor, we are very much clear. When the ID is 0, this is the region. When the ID is nearly 0 or equal to 0, this is referred as a cutoff region. That would be shown here, the cutoff region. Okay. And as you would be increase the VGS further, when the VGS would be, when the VGS would be, when the VGS would be, when the VGS would be greater than the threshold voltage, then you would be see your transistor would be turned on. Okay. So this is the condition, VGS 1, VGS 2 and VGS 3. This is the condition when VGS is greater than VTH, threshold voltage. And VDS is also some positive value. So as you would be directly turned on the this saturation region. And as per the variation of the value of VDS and some other conditions, there is a third region of our operation is also there, V non-saturation. If VDS is less than this particular VDS set, so it would be entered into non-saturation region. If VDS is greater than VDS set, then it would be remains in the saturation. And this saturation region only, your transistor would be act as amplifier. Okay. So we have to be mainly bothered on this particular region, saturation region. Now here operating point is where? So the operating point would be indicate the value of ID and the VDS. You can see the operating point for the VGS Q, that is equal to 2 volt here. So you have, when you have to be draw a line perpendicular to this, so this particular region, it is called as the VDS Q, because this VDS is located on the Q point, and other coordinate of the Q point is the IDQ. It is IDQ. This is here. When you have to draw a tangent to this particular Q point. In this way, we have to be understood the. Similarly, here a voltmeter is connected between drain to source terminal to find out the VDS. Okay. Now, by using the same circuit, we have to be design this circuit. So, in the design, actually, we have to find out the operating point. Okay. We have to find out the operating point. So, what is the coordinate of the operating point? Is there? As per the theory, we have to learn x-axis, that is VDS. Q and y axis, that is IDQ, that we have to be verified. So in our design problem, these two values are mentioned already, as well as the VDD is mentioned. You have to be find out this RG1, RG2, RD and RS. And once you have find out these four resistor values, so use this four resistor and connect the circuit like this. Okay. Any other transistor you are going to use a 2N7000. So connect in this manner and verify that whatever, for whatever the value of VDSQ and IDQ you have designed the circuit, and by using the same value of resistor, similar drain to source voltage and IDQ you are generating or not. You can measure through the multimeter. So now come to the design section. This is the problem for the design. Everyone note down this problem. This is very important for our design. So note it down. Design a single stage MOSFET amplifier in common source configuration using voltage divider bias for given value of VDD. For the given value of the VDD, what? Ten volt and VDS 6.5 volts and IDQ 1 milliamp. This is our design parameter. So these two are the operating points and VDD is the supply voltage. The, using this given information, you have to be design the circuit and find out the RG1, RG2, RD and RS by using the transistor N-channel E-MOSFET 2N7. Okay. Now, how to start the design? First of all, we have to be refer the data sheet of the 2N7000. And by using the data sheet, we have to be take some reference values. And these values are here, refer as the ID on. It is given as a 0.35 ampere. Then VGS on, it is given as a 4.5 volt. And then VGSTH means threshold value, 2.1 volt. Actually, it is given in this particular data sheet. If you have to be, I would be show you the data sheet also. Okay, this is made by the Vijay Electronics. So these are the some values are given that we have to be consider here, and that is specification. Electrical specification we have to be considered. So here, from here, we have to be consider this particular IDN on, ID on, like VGS on, then VGS threshold. This value we have picked up, 2.1 volt, VGSTH, ID on, 0.35 ampere, VGS on, 4.5 volt, like this. So these are the some examples of the that how to choose the data sheet. Okay. Now, if you see as per the design, this much value is given. What values are given here? ID on is taken from the data sheet. Then you have to be choose the VGS on and VGSTH is taken from the data sheet. Now, using this value, apply this formula. What is the formula is here? This is the formula of drain current in saturation region. Because we have designing this circuit to act as an amplifier, so we have to be use the drain current formula for the saturation region. Here, instead of ID, we would be use the term ID on. So here we have used the term ID on. Then KN, KN is not given in the data sheet. We have to find out. Okay. Then we have to be find out. This is given. VGS on is given. VGS TN means threshold value is given. Okay. So by using this information, we have to be find out all the unknown parameters. So what is the formula for KN now? This is the formula for KN. KN is equal to now ID on VGS minus VTH whole square. So what is the value of KN? Calculate please. It is your job now. Start calculating. What is the value of KN now? It is very simple. KN, it is equal to ID on is what? 0.35 ampere. Then VGS on. What is VGS on? 4.5 volts minus what? 2.1 volt whole square. You would be get 0.35 upon 2.4 whole square. So it would be become 0.35 5.76. So what is the value of KN would be some? Tell me. It is ampere per volt. Unit is very much important. So it would be come as anyone has got the value from their calculation. Anyone?
0.0.
Use the calculator.
106.
And type in the
0.060.
0.060 ampere per volt. Correct. Who is this? Who has solved this? Please tell me your name. 0.06076 ampere per volt square. Can we write like this? Kn, it is equal to, in milliampere terms, it is actually in the ampere per volt square. Now we have to write in terms of milliampere per volt square. So for that we have to multiply with the 1000. So it would be become 60.76 milliampere per volt square. This is your conduction parameter. Note it down. Now we have to find, as we have got this Kn, it is very easy now for the design. Now we have to find out the RS and RD. For that purpose, we have to use the KVL on the output loop. And when you apply the KVL, so this is, as per the KVL, we know that. What is the formula for the KVL and the output loop? VDS, VDD minus ID RD minus VDS minus ID RS, it is equal to 0. And when you rearrange this all, you would be got this formula. RD plus RS is equal to VDD minus VDSQ upon ID Q. Now, VDD is given 10 volts. VDSQ is also given. If you remember, it is in the question actually. 6.5 volt. So it is 6.5 divided by IDQ is also given. What is IDQ? It is 1 milliampere. 1 milliampere. So it would be become 3.5 kilo ohm. So 3.5 kilo ohm. Now here we have to be do some assumptions. We have to be do some assumptions. So what assumption you have to be do? Assume RD is equal to twice of RS. For it would be act as a better amplifier, you can always take a drain resistance greater than the source resistance. You can also take RD is equal to RS. It would be also give the stability to the operating point. But for better amplification, you have to be used twice. If you would be do like this, then what would be happen? This equation would be changed. So now it would be become 3RS is equal to 3.5 kilo ohm. So RS is equal to what? RS is equal to what? 3.5 upon 3. So 1.16 kilo ohm. Okay. What is Ankita? Anyone has problem? So RS is your 1.16. Dot is not coming. 1.16 kilo. Now put up on the same equation. You would be find out the RD. Sorry, RD is in this equation. Twice of this. 2 into 1.16. So it would be become what? RD is what?
2.32.
Okay.
32.
This is kilo ohm. So practically 1.16 kilo ohm resistor is not available. So just remember that when you have to be implement this on the breadboard or either in simulation, instead of 1.16, you would be change 1 kilo ohm resistor as a RS. But calculation we would be done on the basis of this. Similarly, for practically RD is either 2 kilo ohm or 2.25 kilo ohm is also possible. Practical resistor is available or 2 kilo ohm resistor. Now, what we have to find out? VGS, VS and VG. So, what is the formula of VG? VS, IDQ into RS. So, find out the VS now. What is the VS? VS is equal to what? ID is 1 milliampere multiplied with the 1.16 kilo ohm. So it would be 1.16 volt. Now find out the VGSQ. So VGSQ is from the current formula of in the saturation region. Okay. Find out VGSQ. And now very less time is there.